A Brentwood man was tased by police tonight at a gun control rally in Concord. A News 9 camera was there as officers took him to the ground. Thanks for staying up with us. I'm Shelley Walcott.
I'm Tom Griffith. Police stepped in shortly after 52-year-old David Musso interrupted a speech in favor of expanded background checks. Our Adam Sexton watched the entire altercation unfold and has our top story tonight.
It started as a rally against gun violence, but it attracted a very strong pro-Second Amendment crowd. Among that crowd was Daniel Musso, who is now facing multiple criminal charges, including simple assault against a police officer.
The names I delivered were the names of young people like my daughter, Melissa. Sir, please have a little respect for this.
I am respectful.
Thank you.
But if you had this speech in your mind, you wouldn't have to read all this propaganda in front of you.
The confrontation started at the podium when Brentwood's Daniel Musso interrupted a speech by John Canton of Manchester. Canton, who was wounded and lost his daughter in a shooting in 2009, was speaking in favor of expanded background checks on gun sales.
Say this is wrong.
Talking about this.
After numerous interjections, Musso decided to walk away, but Concord police had already been summoned. When they started speaking with him, he initiated physical contact, triggering this. Officers struggled to subdue Musso for about a minute and a half before tasing him. Many in the counter-protest felt Musso did nothing wrong.
It wasn't an aggressive move at all.
The rally was part of a bus tour sponsored by Mayors Against Illegal Guns, which has made New Hampshire a battleground on the gun control issue by targeting Senator Kelly Ayotte, who voted against expanding background checks. Some in the gun rights crowd are calling the escalation of the counter-protest and the altercation with police unfortunate.
I don't condone what happened, but at the same time, I still would encourage people to come out peacefully and have their say.
John Canton says he will not be intimidated.
People just need to be more respectful. Don't get so emotional about this. Everybody has a right to their opinion. We're all Americans. We should be able to express that.
Senator Kelly Ayotte's office released a statement tonight regarding her vote on this issue, saying, quote, Senator Ayotte voted for legislation that had bipartisan support to fix the current broken background check system, increase the prosecution of those who illegally seek to obtain firearms, and provide additional resources for school safety while protecting the Second Amendment rights of law-abiding citizens. In the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.